score is 37-34. That's the Lincoln Coach's Corner. I'm here with Phil Jackson. Coach, that's a lot of points. Is that a pace that you like?
No, it's pretty ragged out here. Yeah, it's pretty ragged. There's very excitable teams. Excitable refs, I think, tonight, too. But, yeah, we got a lot of guys in foul trouble, a lot of foul shots, and so far it's a pretty exciting game.
Kobe Bryant's all over the place, already in double-digit scoring. He's had a lane violation, a cut finger, a couple of turnovers. How do you like his activity?
He's been indecisive a couple times, but, you know, he's got that aggressive look in him.
Yeah, thanks a lot. Thank you, Mark.
Heartbreaking and that ragged first quarter, according to Phil Jackson. The Lakers have their highest scoring quarter in this year's playoffs with 37 points. They're high for a first quarter. And Kobe Bryant off to the good start with 10 points. First quarters of the last two games had a total of 2 points. Suns going to their bench as the second quarter gets underway. The shot clock is running down. Two. Marcosa, can he get it off? He does. Rebounded by Bynum.
Very good rotation that time by the Lakers. It's a very good three-point shooting group the Suns have on the floor. Lakers very aware of that. Running at those three-point shooters, making it very difficult long two-point shots.
Sasha Vujacic, who just checked in, able to connect with a three-pointer. He played very well the other night in L.A. To Max Vujacic.
That's what I was talking about, the three-point shooting. This second unit, energy, hustle, three-point shooting is their identity.
And that's exactly what they did. Game four here in Phoenix to tie the series. Odom. Robinson came out of it. The bite of Odom. He missed the trigger with a three-pointer by Shaw. Foul is called. Loose ball foul on Odom.
Healthy, catches that ball and dunks it, and you can see he was such in a hurry, he really never got his hands on the ball cleanly, sort of squirted it up there at the basket. But thank you, Brian, this Vujacic-Dragic matchup now. This is the first time they've been against each other in this game. Remember the other night, because Vujacic really got him out of sync.
There's Robinson. Oh, he's right there. Oh, Robinson. Crowd loves his activity. Game five did not make his usual impact, but game four, he was terrific. 7 points, 7 rebounds. Farmar on the hot toe. Nicely done.
You see more dribble penetration. You saw that the other night in the game. I thought that the Lakers did a much better job driving in the gaps of that zone rather than just passing the ball around the perimeter.
Dragic not able to hit. Handled by Farmar. Farmar and Vujacic in the backcourt are tense with Odom and Bynum up front. Vujacic. Here comes Dragic. Dragic all the way. Brings the Suns within one.
I think you saw some strength from Dragic that too. When you run into Ron Artest like that and you put him on his heels, you get a little strength.
And Artest bottled up by Fry, and Dudley knocked it aside. Last touch by Artest. So again, a good defensive effort by the Suns.
I think there's an important play for Dragic tonight after that game. He missed his first three tonight. He's 1 of 11 now from the three-point line. It's nice to drive in there and get an easy one.
Barbosa. By the blanket. It's smacked by Odom. Knocked away by Amundsen. Farmer trying to settle things down. Just didn't get it across that midcourt line, avoiding the 8-second count. Farmer. Pass nearly picked off. Bynum called for the travel.
Just out of sync. First, you can just see not that smooth. Andrew Bynum normally catches that ball, has very good hands, finishes it. So, Mark, he probably hasn't practiced. I don't know how long with that knee. They're trying to yoke him through this situation. Every time he practices and plays, he gets swelling. And so, it's been a tough stretch for this young guy.
Lakers up by one. Game six of the Western Conference Final. We'll be right back.